Today we are at this airport and I'm gonna fly a plane because I want to. For a while I had this dream of learning how to fly and I thought this was a really good opportunity to do so. So that's why we're here today. I like to know how things work. I like to do things myself, so the more time I spend doing something, the more I want to know how it actually works. And I think that's why I want to learn how to fly myself. I just like a lot of different styles of music and I like a lot of different sounds as well. I don't just like that brutal, distorted, rough sound. I like cleaner sounds as well, especially when it comes to electro, that kind of future electro sound. I'm really, really into that. I don't really care if people expect me to play a certain track or a certain style. If I'm not inspired myself, if I'm bored by what I play, people are gonna see that. So I have to like it myself. I don't really have a problem with that. And I always feel it kind of like translates. If you're enjoying playing, then people will enjoy it as well. I enjoy the fact that people come to see exactly what I do and not just, you know, when you first start out and you play as a support act for another more famous person, a lot of the times you feel like you might have to play a little bit in their style to make it work for the crowd. And if you don't, then the crowd might be a bit like, oh, we don't really want to hear this. And as you get a bit more famous, you can actually do whatever you like and they will go with you because they're there for you. I really like those heavy, nasty sounding synth sounds. And I don't really care if something's analog or not. I only use hardware just because I can't focus when I've got a computer in front of me. I can't make music like that, but that's my personal thing. I don't really care because you know a lot of people, they make amazing stuff just with that and it sounds fantastic. But in general, I like that each machine's got their own little character. And that's what I love about the Drexia sound as well. I'm a big Drexia fan and I love that you can just see the machines running. It's almost like they started press the start button and then it's just the machine doing the rest. It's not just the machine, obviously, but it feels like you just have this machine park. And I once saw Doppler Effect play live and they played and then at the end of their set they just left the stage but the music kept on going. It was just a loop, but it took me like a minute to realize that they were actually gone and that it was just the machine playing now and that there wasn't actually any human being there anymore playing. I thought that was a very interesting picture for like a live show like that. Yeah, I just like having synthesizers and looking at them, they just look very pretty. I'm looking for the perfect sound. But my idea of a perfect sound is maybe different to other people's idea of that. I like it when it sounds grainy and rough and a bit fucked up. But the sound is my first priority. My first priority is probably just the energy of track. I think there is no right and wrong in music. It's not scientific, it's just like a feeling. I don't think my taste in music is any better or worse than anyone else's taste. It's just my taste. There's a lot of stuff that I really, really don't like. And I think it's bad music, but I don't feel like I can be the judge of that. So I don't like the word teaching, but I like to share music with people. And if they've never heard this track before, if they've never heard this kind of style before, then I think it's cool. I mean, you can show them something and other people can show me stuff that I've never heard of before. So it's just like exchanging ideas and knowledge and just things you came across. I'm not on Facebook and what's the other one? Instagram. Everybody's got an image, whether you want or not, but I'm really not bothered about creating one for myself. I mean, posting things that might create, like, of course, I mean, you wear clothes, you've got your style of DJ, you do interviews and the way you come across and stuff, everything is an image. But, you know, whatever you post, it's like, yeah, I've been here, I've seen this, I've seen that. I always feel a bit, don't really like it, don't know. But then yeah, I'm gonna be on a plane and I'm gonna get filmed doing that, so I should better shut my mouth.